All right, what's up, people? All right, we're about to read some Bible scriptures for you. I'm book of 2 Thessalonians, 2nd chapter. Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and by our gathering together unto him. So that's how we're going to gather together, is by being out here on the streets, waking people up, bringing people to the Lord. We're out here harvesting, pretty much. 2 Thessalonians 2:2. That ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter, as from us, as the day of Christ is at hand. That's what we telling all these fools out here, that the day of the Lord is at hand. And just before we got up here, an old man told us he can't wait till this shit gets destroyed. And this society is about to be destroyed by the Lord. 2 Thessalonians 2:3. Let no man deceive you by any means. So as we telling people, don't be deceived. We got a lot of homosexual agnostics and atheists. They'll try to say, oh, God doesn't exist. While at the same time, they're a bunch of homosexuals. And they have sex with animals. Because I talked to thousands and thousands of people, and almost every person I ever met that said they was agnostic or atheist ended up being a homosexual. So that's homosexuality is one of the symptoms of being an atheist or an agnostic. And there's nothing scientific about being a homosexual. There's no scientific basis for that. So all these atheists who claim to be scientists, but they're homosexuals, how is being a homosexual scientific? It's actually insanitary. It causes diseases. Oh, I'm not going into that. 2 Thessalonians 2:3. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there be a falling away first. I'm going to wait till this stupid truck goes by. I'm not talking about that. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there be a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, who's the son of perdition. That's why we know we're in the last days, because there's an extreme falling away from this Bible. There's not too many people that believe in the Bible anymore. Like back in the 1950s and before that time period, everybody in this country, for the most part, believed in the Bible. Now, for the most part, most people were raised on the Bible. They were raised on the Ten Commandments. But now, children don't even know what the Ten Commandments are. They never even heard of the Ten Commandments before. It's a damn shame. That's what it is. It's a damn shame. But that's good, though. It's really good, because now we know we're in the end time. Because the scripture said there's going to be a falling away. It said there'll be a falling away first, and then the man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. That's talking about the so-called Illuminati, the elites that control this planet. The bankers. The technocratic elite, okay? Who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God. Just like at all these so-called universities. They always put themselves above God. All these scientists put themselves above God. All the rulers and the kings of the earth put themselves above God. Now they say there is no God. They say we're God. Who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. That's exactly what the elite of the world do. That's what all that so-called educational institutions do. They say there is no God and we're God. Like Richard Dawkins. Richard Dawkins is one of the biggest homosexuals you ever see. But he spends so much time and effort speaking out against God. He hates Bible believers so much that he spends almost all of his life talking about it. Now, if Richard Dawkins was a real scientist, which he is not, wouldn't he be spending most of his time doing science? Okay, what has Richard Dawkins contributed to the world? What kind of great inventions or great discoveries has he had? None. But the greatest scientist of all time was Isaac Newton. He was a Christian, and he discovered the laws of gravity and gave his calculus. What has Richard Dawkins done? Nothing. He's a homosexual. Who opposed him and exalted himself above all that is called God. You know, another one that does that is that Neil. What's up, bro? Chillin'.
No.
It's a scripture. Feels good to be out here. I'm in the middle of Thessalonians. We're just talking about these fake-ass scientists and agnostics and atheists.
Might as well wait on that fucking
light. Oh yeah, like Richard Dawkins and Neil. What's that one? Neil deGrasse Tyson. You know who that guy is? I watch a lot of his videos on YouTube. You know, on PBS, he's that black scientist. He on PBS. He's real popular. But his whole thing is disproving God and being against God. He's always giving sermons and lectures. He's always giving lectures and presentations about atheism and how everybody should be an atheist. And he believes that no scientist should be allowed to believe in God. That's what Neil deGrasse Tyson believes. So you know that dude, he's set up by the elite. And what kind of great scientific achievements has Neil deGrasse Tyson had? Oh, he's one of the big people, he's one of the main people that changed Pluto from a planet into a planetoid. It's not even a planet no more. That was his great accomplishment, contribution to society. He's saying that Pluto is not a planet no more. Like, what kind of science? That dude's not even a scientist. He ain't discovered shit. All right, let me get this, man. 2 Thessalonians, you can read this if you want. Get 2 Thessalonians 2 and 5.
There's one right there, guy. Guy, there's one right there.
Oh, we got one. Here, you can use this. What is this? 2 Thessalonians 2 and 5. I was reading some Thessalonians. It's just going in talking about how we in the end times. Shouldn't say he's on the way out here.
Oh, yeah, that's
all. All right, that's good.
I had to get out here.
You know, they deleted our YouTube channel again. Yes. Yeah, 2 Thessalonians 2 and 5. So these videos right here, these are going to be the first videos up on a new channel. I ain't made it yet, though.
So, 2 Thessalonians 2 and 5. Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things.
Yeah, this is Paul, because Paul, just keep going. That's why we telling everybody on YouTube these things and everybody on the streets these things. Keep going.
And now ye know what withholdeth that he might be revealed in his time.
Keep going.
For the mystery of iniquity doeth already work.
So this all kind of, the mystery of iniquity is really not a mystery, is it? You can look around in society, it's as wicked as can be, man. We got damn Satanists walking around on the streets, transsexuals walking on the streets. We got women commit abortions at an accelerated rate. I think most women that have 5 abortions by the time they're 18. So this place is just filthy and foul, man. Keep going.
Only he who now will let until he be taken out of the way.
So he's gonna be taken out of the way. So another thing they're doing to us, what are they doing? They putting fluoride and all kind of chemicals in our water. They feeding us genetically modified food. They send your children to a mind control camp that they call school, a government mind control camp. They shooting your children up with all kind of vaccinations, killing them, making you retarded. Keep going. When they all gonna get pushed out of the way, all these devils doing this. Oh, do you hear about that story? There were cows down in Texas that ate some genetically modified grass and it killed the cows. You hear that? They genetically modified the grass so that the bugs wouldn't eat it. Hold on. They just, these fools genetically modified the grass so the bugs wouldn't eat it, and it would kill the bugs if the bugs ate it. But now the cows ate the grass and the cows died. So what the hell do you think is gonna happen to the people that ate that cow? They gonna drop dead too. So go ahead. So all these fools, all these devils doing that to us, they gonna get pushed out the way. They gonna get destroyed, man. All Monsanto's gonna get destroyed. Keep going.
Then shall that wicked be revealed.
So the wicked's already being revealed. We reveal the wicked by doing shows, by making videos. There's all kinds. You get on the internet, there's all kind of wickedness being revealed on YouTube, man. All kind of people making videos exposing this wicked ass government. You know what I mean? Keep going.
Whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming.
And right now the Lord's using us as a mouthpiece, you know what I'm saying? But soon when the Lord comes back out of the heavens, he's gonna set the world on fire, man. Especially this place that we in right now. The Lord's gonna set this place on fire. Going.
Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, all power and signs and lying wonders.
Yeah, lying wonders. So who? That's a bad scripture. Keep going. Yeah, we live in Satan's kingdom. Now let me get a scripture to back that up real quick. Just hold that. We're gonna get right back to that. I'm gonna get one to back that up. We actually literally live in Satan's kingdom, man. So we live in modern day Rome. Because America's based on Rome. And what was Rome? Rome was pagan. They worshiped Zeus in Rome. And what was Zeus represented by? Zeus was represented by the eagle. Just like America's represented by the eagle. Because we live in neo-pagan Rome. This is the new Rome. You know, pretty much. Where's that? Revelation 2 and 1 second, I gotta find it. It's been a minute since I got it. Oh, here it is, I got it. Revelation 2 and 13. I know thy works and where thou dwellest. So the Lord knows where we live, even where Satan's seed is. So the Lord said Satan's seed is right here in America. That's what he's saying. Because originally this was talking about Rome, the Roman Empire, okay? But now it's talking about the Roman Empire. It never changed. There's no new thing under the sun. The Roman Empire is right here in America. And that's a fact. Thomas Jefferson, he tell you he was inspired by the Romans. I know that works. Say another thing. That's why America was founded as a republic. Because they was trying to emulate the ancient Romans. Because the ancient Romans had a republic. And then it turned into an empire ruled by an emperor, ruled by a Caesar. And pretty much now the president is turned into a Caesar. Because the president, he's the Caesar, he's the king. He's a dictator. Obama's a dictator. Well, really, he's just a puppet. But still, they put him on the level of the emperor, the Caesar. The same with Bush and all the rest of them. People think we just talking about Obama. We don't like none of them devils. I know that works and where thou dwellest, even where Satan's seat is, and thou holdest fast my name. So what's the Lord's name? He said you gotta hold fast his name. The Lord's name is Yahweh Bahasham Yahweh Shah. And thou holdest fast my name and has not denied my faith. So do you deny the faith of the Lord? So we ain't we not gonna fuck with people. But we're not gonna deny the Lord. I pity the fool to deny the Lord. I pity you. Like Mr. T said, I pity the fool. And I has denied my faith even in those days when Antipas was my faithful martyr who was slain among you where Satan dwelleth. They want to kill us. If you teach this truth, people want to kill you. They want to see you dead. The government probably want to disappear your ass. They don't want to hear you teaching this truth, pushing the Bible. They ain't trying to hear that shit, man. Go ahead, get back to that Thessalonians. I just wanted to bring out that point because we live in Satan's kingdom, man.
All this. Of unrighteousness in them that perish because they receive not the love of the truth that they might be saved.
It is the love of the truth. So there's all kinds of deceiving and lying wonders going on. Like your boy Obama. He came out on national TV saying it's okay for a man and woman to get married and they should be allowed to get married. But he claims to be a Christian. But that's a deceiver. That's a lying wonder. And then everybody believes him because he's black. Since Obama's black, everybody believes him. He's the savior. He's God. Because these people are so stupid and so simple and so retarded that they can't see that this dude is set up by the white man. Keep going.
It's called God shall send them
to delusion. So the Lord has sent all these fools all kinds of delusions, man. Like they actually so these people are so delusional that they think that like a woman having an abortion and that's not murder. And that's how delusional they are. They so delusional that they think it's okay for a woman to have five baby daddies and to be able to have sex with 1,000 different men. That's a delusion, man. And these motherfuckers send you a delusion when they say that the Bible's not true. That's a delusion. When you going to school and they teaching your children about evolution in school, man, that's a delusion. They training your children to be Satanists, pretty much. Training your children to be a bunch of damn devils, man. And then you happily send your children off to these evil ass public schools, man. Keep going.
And for this cause, God shall send them strong delusions that they should believe a lie.
So yeah, all these people out here talking about they're agnostic, they're atheists, they believing in lies. And then you ask them why they're agnostic or atheist, they can't even give you a good answer. They can't even debate their own cause. They just heard it on TV, so that's what they believe. Whatever the TV tells them to believe, that's what they believe. Keep going.
They all might be damned who believe not the truth, but have pleasure in unrighteousness.
So if you don't believe in the truth, you are damned. So people say we can't say you're going to be damned, you're going to be destroyed. But the Bible said that you damned. If you don't believe in this truth, you are damned. I'm going to get a precept for that. That's how rough the Bible is. It just comes straight out with it, man. It don't cut no corners. It comes straight at you. I got it right here. Mark 16:16. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. That's in the Holy Bible. The Bible said, if you reject the truth, that you are damned, you're going to be destroyed. There's no doubt about that. All right, get back to Thessalonians.
But we are bound to give thanks always to God for you, brethren.
He said, we are, my fault, man, interrupt you. That's a good point. He said, we are bound. Read that again.
But we are bound to give thanks always to God for you, brethren, beloved of the Lord.
So, yeah, so we're bound to give thanks. That means we're slaves to the Lord. These fools, man. He's over here honking at me. Fucking idiot. So we're servants of the Lord. We're slaves to the Most High. We're slaves to our brothers. We're our brothers' servants. Keep going. That's the only reason we're coming out here is to help our brothers. To hell with everybody else, man. We're out here to serve people, man. We're servants. Keep going.
Because God had from the beginning chose you to salvation through sanctification of the Spirit and belief of the truth.
The sanctification of the Spirit. And he knows it also said that we was chosen from the beginning. So everything in this life is predestined. Everything we do is predestined. The Lord already chose the elect before the earth was even formed. We were chosen before we were even born. Before we popped out our mama's coochie, we were already chosen. The elect was already sealed. Keep going.
Because God had from the beginning chosen you to salvation through sanctification of the Spirit and belief of the truth, whereunto he called you by our gospel to the obtaining of the glory of our Lord Yahweh Shai.
Yes, Yahweh Shai, that's the glory, nothing else. Keep going.
Therefore, brethren, stand fast and hold the traditions which ye have been taught, whether by word or by epistle.
Yeah, so like, yeah, by the scriptures or by a brother teaching the scriptures? Keep going.
Now our Lord Yahweh Shai himself and God, even our Father, which have loved us and have given us everlasting consolation and good hope and grace, comfort your hearts and sadness in every good word and work.
Yeah, so one of the main reasons we do all these videos, though, because believe it or not, us out here teaching the Bible comforts brothers, you know what I mean? When they get on YouTube and they watch some videos, it gives them some comfort. It makes them feel like they got a friend, someone that is there for them. Now that sounds kind of gay. But that's true though, you know what I mean? That's true. That this word comforts you. It feels good when you hear it. All right, go, Chan. We need the motherfucking house now. Let's go. Hey. Nah, it's just my fault. Nah, Chan's right there. You keep reading. Oh, we can wait till he gets here.
2 Thessalonians 3.
What's up, bro?
What's up, fellas?
What's up?
Is that your Chinese girl you brought with you?
Yeah, that's me, man. Don't even look at her.
She's too small for you, Chan.
She's nice size for me. I like it too.
Big, Chan.
I like them 4 foot tall girls, man.
Had a screw like that.
Be eating cat.
Had a few like that.
He said you passed your limit.
Fish from Thailand was like that.
Huh? The who?
I had a fish from Thailand.
Thailand?
Yeah, it was like that.
I had like 1,000 of Thailand fishes. But I went to Thailand. That shouldn't be on camera.
You just gave him all kinds of footage.
Oh, okay, I guess it's a crime to have sex with women, though, so... But they want
to
hate
us. You're supposed to have sex with women.
They want... Oh, yeah. They want... Yeah, that was in my younger years. So if I'm the devil for having sex with 1,000 Thailand women, so be it. How you gonna... Let's read that. He's in 2 Thessalonians. He's in the spirit out here.
Oh, that's a good one.
2 Thessalonians 3. Finally, brethren, pray for us the word of our Lord may have free course and be glorified even as it is with you.
Yep. So we're going to glorify the Most High out here. Keep going.
And that we may be delivered from unreasonable and wicked men.
Oh, yeah. We're going to be delivered from unreasonable and wicked men. Hey, yo, these court systems are unreasonable. You know what I mean? Every time you get a ticket. First of all, what is a ticket? A ticket's not even a crime. Is that... A crime is like when you punch someone in the face. That's a crime. Even when you park in a meter for too long, that's a crime. And then they give you a $70 ticket for having your car parked somewhere. But that's some bullshit, man. That's unreasonable. And then they'll lock men up for not, they'll lock you up if you don't pay your whore's ex-wife child support. Here it is, your woman was being a whore, having sex with all kind of men, then she leaves you, and then she makes you pay child support, and then the court, they protect the adulteress, and then they make a good righteous man have to pay child support to a goddamn whore and an adulteress, to a woman that should have been put to death in a righteous society. So, man, this place is fucked up, man. No, keep going. I just get angry, man. You just read them scriptures, make you, I just get angry.
But the Lord is faithful, who shall establish you and keep you from evil.
So the Lord gonna protect us from evil. So say you do got a baby mama drama, don't worry about it. You know why? Because the Lord's gonna destroy that bitch, man. Keep going.
And we have confidence in the Lord touching you that ye both do and will do the things which we command you. And the Lord directs your hearts into the love of God and into the patient waiting of Yahweh Shai, for Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, so that's real love is Yahweh Shai. And that's our main emphasis. That's the main thing we're going to emphasize is Yahweh Shai, the Son of God. That's the only reason we out here. Keep going.
And the Lord directs your heart into the love of God and into the patient waiting for Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, patient waiting, you can't lose patience. You can't lose faith, you know what I mean? This was written 2,000 years ago. Did Paul, did he lose faith? No, Paul kept his faith until he was executed by Nero. Peter kept his faith until he was crucified upside down. It was faithful unto death. There's actually a scripture that says to be, we already read it, didn't we? To be faithful unto death. I'm not sure if we read that or not, Revelation. Keep going. Because death ain't shit anyway, man. You can't be afraid of death, all right? We all gonna die anyway.
You ain't really dying anyway.
Yeah, we're all dead men walking anyway. Well, right. I mean, in the physical sense, we're all dead men walking anyway. And no man escapes death, you know what I'm saying? Except for one. But, Yahweh Shai escaped death. He conquered death. But, there's really no such thing as death. We're immortal spirits, okay? We're eternal, man. That's why the scripture said that we were chosen before the earth was even formed. So if there's such thing as death, how could we have been chosen before the earth was formed? That, reincarnation. Before.
That's too hard for some people to stomach.
Yep.
So that's why they fall out of this, man. They can't take some shit that meat.
Because all they think that exists is this earthly body. Yeah. They don't understand that we have a heavenly body. Like after you die, you go to the spirit world and you take on a different form of existence. You know what I'm saying? Every person and every animal and every plant has a spirit. Everything.
Everything the Lord created.
Everything that, right, he said he put his spirit in it. His ruach. The Lord put his ruach in it. Keep going.
Now we command you, brethren, in the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai, that you withdraw yourself from every brother that walketh disorderly.
Oh, yeah.
Did that say disorderly?
Yeah. The Bible said, read that again.
Now we command you, brethren, in the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai, that you withdraw yourself from every brother that walketh disorderly.
So you're not supposed to be hanging out with some damn Muslims and hanging out with some old gangsters or some Bloods and Crips. You're not supposed to hang out with no damn, no heathens.
No good ass wannabe Israelites.
Wannabe Israelites.
They supposed to do some of the law.
Yeah, you ain't supposed to kick it with no Baptists. You know, Jehovah Witnesses. Talking about, yeah, this is my homies, Jehovah. Jehovah's almost got the truth. No, they don't. Almost got, they got destruction. keep going. You know, people try to compromise, man. You can't compromise, man.
Yeah.
Compromise leads to slavery.
Just for numbers' sake, just so the camp can get bigger or the church can get bigger.
Just like politicians, they're always compromising. Politicians are always compromising their own beliefs, and that's why the political system is so corrupt, because everybody compromises their beliefs. Keep going. I like your boy Rand Paul. Your boy Rand Paul just sold out all of his stupid ass followers. But that's good for them, because they're a bunch of retards anyway. But you see what happened? He compromised and sold everybody out.
Sold them out? I think that was set up.
Yeah, I think it was set up too.
They all look like goddamn idiots.
They look foolish as hell right now. Alex Jones, I was listening to Alex Jones. He pretty much was like, the hell with Ron Paul. He's like, you're not coming back on my show again. He actually said that shit.
Right.
He was feeling, that's because Alex Jones was feeling so stupid. He just felt so salty. I ain't used that word in years, salty.
Right.
He didn't feel salty.
Philippians, let me read this real quick. Philippians 1:27. Only let your conversations be as it becometh the gospel of Yahweh Shai, that whether I come and see you or else be absent, I may hear of your affairs, that you stand fast in one spirit, with one mind, striving together for the faith of the gospel.
Yeah, that's a good scripture. Yeah, we're all supposed to have one mind striving together. You can't have a billion different doctrines, man. Everybody believing in different crazy stuff. Because people teach crazy shit, man. Like this, a lot of people on YouTube. I just made a video about it yesterday, so it's fresh in my brain. But we got a lot of people teaching that the scribes and Pharisees descend from Cain, or that they descend from Esau. I mean, that's madness.
Where you find that shit at?
All kind of people teach it.
Oh, I got to find some of that. They don't want to hear what I got to say.
I mean, it's just so, I mean, that's just one example of the madness that people's teaching, man.
Yeah, where they come up with that bugged out shit at? So they heard it from someone else, and they repeat it.
And then you got the Enoch people. We all know about the Book of Enoch people. So that's another group of madness. The Enoch and the fallen angel people. So nobody's in the same spirit, man.
Enoch and the Nephilim.
Everybody got to get on the same page.
But it ain't gonna happen.
It ain't gonna happen. Well, it will happen for the elect, you know.
It's gonna happen on the other side too.
Yeah, not on this side.
I got something. Let me find Philippians. I'm gonna start at 2. I'm starting to talk.
Yeah, Philippians is badass.
If there be therefore any consolation in Yahweh Shai, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any bowels of mercy, fulfill ye my joy, that ye be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord, of one mind.
They say you can't. What is another scripture talking about around with different doctrines? Mm-hmm. You can't be having like a billion different doctrines, everybody teaching 1,000 different things,
right,
man.
Right.
It causes confusion. And then you got all kind of women teachers, and good Lord, we know that causes all kind of confusion. Women do making videos on YouTube. What kind of madness is that, man?
Where's the love?
And it's all you men, man. It's your fault, man. And then the men automatically follow the woman. They're like, oh, her voice is so sexy.
You ever seen that white chick with her two daughters? It's on YouTube. She was on that one model bitch that got her own talk show. The model bitch, decent looking, black chick.
You talking about
Tyra Banks?
I
yeah.
Hate that bitch, man.
And the white girl and her two daughters, man, mama. Teenage daughters too. They all look good. She coming with the spirit, the fiery spirit of the Lord. The Lord's coming to kill. The Lord hate adulterers.
Oh, I seen that.
You seen that?
Yeah, I was mad as fuck watching that video.
Yeah, but she only knew one scripture.
Yeah, but the whole
crowd. I only think she knew one.
But the whole crowd started booing her.
Yeah, they threw her.
Yeah, it was wicked. And the whole crowd was filled with number of women, man. You women are wicked and evil, man.
Yeah.
You the women are the problem. You the problem with everything. You the cause. The scripture said that women is the beginning of sin, and through her we all die. We're not saying it because we hate women, because we love women. We like women, trust me. We want to collect women, okay?
Trade them.
Yeah.
Like trade baseball cards. We want to have our day for all that. But those women were Jake's, man.
Oh, yeah, Jake is going to say that.
Yeah.
Only an Israelite is going to... Only righteousness will only proceed out of the mouth of an Israelite. That's it. The devil does not teach truth.
If he is, he's being deceitful. He don't know truth anyway, but he uses his book to deceive the shit out of him.
Yep.
Let's just show you that show, man. All those women just...
That's why a lot of you, there's probably some hillbillies down south from down south or something.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of them down south hillbillies are Israelites, man.
Hell yeah.
Well, we
all
see a lot.
Motherfuckers that's living in the back mountains, kidnapping motherfuckers, putting them in cages, them Israelites.
Shit. Out there living in back in the holler.
Right.
Living back, living off the land, living off the holler. Got about, they got a whole armory in their cabin. They got like 50 guns.
They just found another one the other day, the one they had a girl put away.
A 55-pound 14-year-old?
That was a black chick that was doing that one.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that was a black chick that was doing that one.
But Israel is the wicked of all the wicked.
That's a heathen right there.
What's up, heathen?
I like to kick one of them motherfuckers when I see it.
The scriptures tell you how wicked them damn Israelites are. It's all through the Bible. The Lord cursed not the Israelites more than anybody else.
Yeah, a bunch of fucking liars and deceivers. That's what Israel is. That's what 2/3 of it is, a bunch of liars and deceivers.
And y'all was created to be the chosen people, the holy people.
Yeah.
You were separated from the other nations to be holy, but instead you want to act like heathens. You know what I mean?
Mm.
You want to follow after the ways of the heathen.
Yeah.
Go back to that festival. Look at this group of heathens over here. Get them on camera. Look at that. Alright, let's go. That's like what we call a gaggle of heathens, a horde of heathens. A heathen horde.
And not after the tradition which saved us. For yourself know how you ought to follow us, for we behave not ourselves disorderly among you.
Yeah, well, so we're not disorderly, man. We're not always acting all wild and crazy. You know, we're like calm, collective type people, you know what I mean? We're not always out trying to start fights, getting drunk and acting wild and crazy like we did in our younger years. You know, we act like grown people, man. Civilized people. Keep going. And we following the laws of the Bible, man. We're gonna do what the Bible said to do. We're not gonna follow after the traditions and the customs of man. Just because the TV says it's okay to do something doesn't mean it's okay. We're gonna do what the Bible said to do. Go ahead. That's a bunch of.
Let me read this real quick.
That's nothing but damn women.
Let me read this real quick, bro. Colossians 2:8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
We have a lot of that. Like I said, everybody now is popular to be an agnostic and an atheist. Now it's popular to be a Buddhist and a Hindu. He got yoga shops all over the damn place. That all goes back to the ancient witchcraft, man. Keep going.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit. After the tradition of men. After the rudiments of the world and not after Yahawashah.
People don't want to follow the laws of the Bible. People want to call themselves great Americans. I'm a patriot. You know, they're like, I'm a great American patriot. And they have no problem with following all the laws in America, which are like 2 million. They have a problem with following 613 laws of the Bible. They have a problem with that.
Hell, they have a problem just eating pork. Just stop eating pork.
Yeah, they have a problem.
Just that one.
Yeah, they don't want to believe in God because you can't eat pork.
Yeah.
Maybe. You know, people like that just need exterminated.
Of course, man.
Yeah, I can't wait till the government starts exterminating people.
Come up with your sorry asses.
That's
get scrumptious.
I hope they get hit with that new bird flu, man.
I hope they do.
Yeah, bird flu, swine flu, zombie flu. I hope y'all get all kind of diseases. I hope you get locked up in concentration camps.
They saying West Nile is at the beaches now.
That's good. I hope everybody at the beach get bit by a damn mosquito.
I hope so. I pray so.
Some genetically engineered mosquito. Wait, it probably got diseases already.